In this video, I'll show you a couple quick ways to add motion to your Midjourney images. To clarify, these online tools will work with 2D images created from virtually any program. They also work with hand sketches, paintings, and photographs. If you're anything like me, and you've been experimenting with Midjourney for a few weeks, you may be entering a phase I'm calling the shallow impact. I've generated hundreds of images, specifically architectural-based, and although they serve as great inspiration, I think many architects and designers are already eager for the next leap from 2D to 3D. We can partially achieve this leap now by giving our images depth. There are numerous programs online that will generate depth maps from an uploaded image. This is a popular one called Midas, which runs on the Hugging Face website, which I will link in the description. You simply upload your image, click submit, and an approximated depth map will be generated. You can then right-click or control-click on a Mac to open the image in another browser, and before saving it, make sure to enlarge the image if possible. From this point, there are fewer programs that will accept uploaded depth maps to create animations, but this one, called Depth Map Viewer, does a good job. I'll provide a link in the description for this website, and once you're here, you simply upload your original 2D image, and then upload the generated depth map image, and click Initialize Scene. If you receive this error message, simply click Wait, and the sequence will eventually upload. Once it does, click the Start Animation button to begin the animation. You'll see your image begin to rotate from side to side. There are a few parameters with slider controls along the right-hand side of the screen that may benefit your image type. Here, you can control the number of animated frames, set the distance crop plane, move the camera forward or back, increase the effect of the depth map, and increase or decrease the animated rotation angle. When you're finished with your adjustments, click Update Parameters to refresh the animation, then click Create GIF. Your GIF will generate, and then you can right-click or control-click to save. I was impressed with the amount of depth and rotation generated in this viewer. The only issue I experienced was the wait time for the images to process. I was told by the creator of this tool that it works best with smaller images, so try to keep your images below 500 kilobytes. The next option is called Leiapix Converter, and I will provide a link in the description. It is much more user-friendly and generates its own depth map from any image you upload. I'll upload the same image so we can compare with the previous viewer. At the left-hand side of the screen, there are a few settings we can control, such as the speed of the animation, which I'll keep at 6 seconds, the animation style, which gives you some options to change the camera path, which I like set to horizontal only, the amount of motion, which reduces or increases the camera panning effect, and the camera focus point, which will move the rotational point forward or back, giving you a slightly different perception of the image. A useful feature on this site is the Depth Map Editor. It allows you to make edits to the depth map right here on the site, using a Photoshop-style paintbrush. There's also a picker and a level sampler to match the properties of the auto-generated depth map. It takes a minute to learn how sensitive the adjustment sliders are on the brush settings, but once you master it, editing and refining the depth map really helps to bring your image to life. In this case, I'll sample this area back here and give this recessed nook in the foreground a little more depth. When you're finished editing, click Preview to view your changes. And when you're ready to export the animation, click the Share button and choose from the different options available. In this case, I'll export my animations as an MP4 file with the option to keep the animation full size. It takes less than a minute to generate, and then you can save the file wherever you prefer. To conclude, here are a few Midjourney images I animated using this depth map viewer. As mentioned earlier, I believe there is a lot of excitement surrounding text-to-image AI technology. It seems to be a welcomed tool by many designers across various disciplines. But besides experimenting by collaging unrelated typologies, creating otherworldly biomimicry products, fields of luminescent robotic flowers, dystopian Gaudi-inspired rainforests, or whatever vibrant candy-themed noun you can think of, I personally am ready to put this technology to the test to create functional, purposeful, and meaningful designs that have real-world application. Thanks for watching, and please let me know if you have any questions, comments, or would like to discuss any philosophy surrounding this matter.